Hello all, and welcome to this night's beer review, which I am dubbing the, exhaustion beer review. For some reason, I've just been very tired. I've been having insomnia the past few days, and I'm not sure that drinking alcohol is a good cure for that, but, we're going to do it anyway, because I like drinking beer, and this is the time I get to drink it. What are we going to be reviewing tonight? Well, I'm pretty sure that any of you who are watching beer reviews sort of know about this thing here. Beginning of autumn, this sort of was rolled out, and it's an effort by many breweries across the world to, fund black charities, I suppose. I wasn't paying too good of attention to, I know it's charitable, but I wasn't paying too good of attention as to the foundation or foundations or how it was organized or anything like that, because that stuff doesn't interest me. Beer does. But it was in support of black people, given the current Black Lives Matter movement and whatnot. And that's about as political as I'm going to get for these beer reviews. Anyways, so multiple breweries went and brewed this, and a open source recipe was put out for this Imperial Stout. And this one was made by Maui Brewing in Hawaii, so I guess it counts, falls under the rubric of local beers, and I'm going to review it. Now, what I find interesting is that the ABV was different for some of these, despite using the same recipe. And, other beer review channels and blogs have reviewed multiple iterations of this and found differences. I'm afraid my palate might not be that refined, however, to do that kind of thing. And I'd like to see someone try to do a blindfold on that one, a blindfold taste test on that one, see if it could really suss out the differences. I would go and see if it's like super taster, trained super tasters or a real deal sort of thing going on there. But anyways, 9.5 ABV, I've seen it anywhere in between like 10.2 and 9.5. I also have for me today a mug of black tea with cacao nibs. So something matching taste with taste. Unfortunately, I have no chocolate or coffee to have with this. Not that I really want coffee this late at night. I want to sleep. For love of God, I want to sleep. So this has been warming up for about 10 minutes already. Let's just go and pour it out and start reviewing, shall we? Already yammered on for a while. Just a moment. Pouring it into the stout glass, as you can see here. And this is almost completely opaque, just a little amber brown light shining through at the very bottom, the thinnest part of the glass. With a beige to light brown head here. Thick and foamy. And just absolutely redolent with sweet cacao notes. Light coffee. A strong dark malt base. And just a hint of flavoring hops. I've seen, this posted on other sites as about 20 IBU units. So, let's get to the tasting, shall we? Hmm. One of the most chocolatey imperial stouts I've ever had. Just big chocolate up front. Very oily mouth texture. And a lasting finish that is bittering hops and residual malt sweetness. Nice cacao notes, you know, sort of not processed chocolate, but sort of raw chocolate in the midst to finish. And some coffee in the finish. I'm actually really enjoying this because there's not too much booziness, actually. It does seem like this is really high in residual sugars, leading to an overall sweet mouthfeel. Not milk chocolate sweet, but definitely bittersweet chocolate sweet, as opposed to, you know, like 70% dark cacao. This is more like 40%, I would say. One brief flash of a slight off flavor in the mid to finish. Very quickly past this though. Little bit of a tinniness. I don't know what that is. Thankfully, not overhopped. I really don't like strongly hopped stouts, as you may have heard on me saying before. Dark malts and heavy hops percentages don't do well on my palate. All in all, very enjoyable. Not particularly complex for a style that a lot of people find very complex. I've never really been able to suss out as much from Imperial Stouts as some people have. Being, you know, these super heavy beers are really not my jam. But, you know, it's for a good cause. And I just kind of wanted to... give it a shot, you know, it's a local beer. A local beer is also a national beer, I suppose. International. So, if you like Imperial Stouts, super dark Imperial Stouts, especially ones that sort of lean more towards the chocolatey tasting notes as opposed to the coffee-like tasting notes, definitely go and give this one a shot. I believe that some places, a lot of places actually, still have this on the shelf or on tap. Go and try it. And unlike most local beers, you know, Hawaiian beers, I live in Hawaii, so when I talk about local beers, I'm referring to beers made in Hawaii. You know, this is being brewed across the nation and across the world, so give it a try if this kind of beer is your jam. This is not my jam. I'm still really enjoying it, though. And yeah, the alcohol is kind of making my nose run. That's another reason why you don't see me drinking super high ABV beers. Something about it just causes my nose to run. So yeah, I'm probably going to cut this video short right now because unless I blow my nose, it's going to start running down my upper lip here, and I won't be able to smell it. Even worse, I won't be able to smell and taste my beer anymore. So that's your beer review for tonight, folks. Give this one a shot if you're into this. Black is beautiful. Cheers.